my channel, and today I'll be doing a different video for all of you. And I think this is the first time that I'll be doing this kind of video, and I'll be giving you some acrylic painting tips. And this is not about the specific paintbrush or paints that you have to use. I'll be talking about how to not discourage yourself and how not to be discouraged by others when it comes to your artwork, and also some painting advice to motivate yourself as well. So yeah, let's begin now. So my first advice for you, I've actually written down some points so that I remember each one of them, because each one of them has a certain importance. They are not ranked in any particular manner, but yeah. So my first tip is for you to practice. Nothing beats action when it comes to your art journey. Unless you're a critic, because a critic, as we all know, they are usually the one who talk more about the art of others. And if they are an artist as well, probably they are like the talker and the doer at the same time. But most of the time they criticize or they give criticisms. Of course, that's their job, and it's really up to you how to take it. Sometimes they compliment, sometimes even if it's a criticism and they tell you to take it constructively, it's gonna hurt you, because you know you're the artist. You actually took time to create the artwork and you just got that comment from a person, and most especially if that person is well known in the industry, right? It's gonna hurt you. But then again, if you keep practicing, if you keep doing art, nothing beats that, because you are going to immortalize yourself through the means of your own painting. The world is gonna know. And keep on practicing, because the only way to learn how to paint is to actually do it. If you listen to those criticisms, maybe they are right, maybe they are wrong, but if you keep doing what you love, if you just do what you do, you're gonna learn on your own. And that is so true, because I've done that. I've experienced that myself. And I must say that some teachers have helped me, some teachers on YouTube as well, because I used to watch YouTube tutorials before, and they've inspired me so much they have this technique, so I might as well like apply it on my own artwork so that it helps me. And I'm so grateful for them. I'm so grateful for all the lessons that they've given me. And now I'm learning to do my own techniques, and I cannot deny that they are a part of it. But keep doing art. You know, as I was telling you guys, doing is different from talking about it. Some people talk about your art, but you keep doing it. And as time goes by, you'll see yourself creating a lot of artwork, and you'll be just proud of yourself for doing all these things. And criticisms that hurt you, as time goes by, they won't matter to you anymore. They won't matter to you, because think of it this way. If a hurtful word hurts you right now, imagine yourself 5 years later. Will it still hurt you, or it won't matter anymore, right? So like, learn how to take your battles. Choose your battles wisely, okay? So just keep creating, keep doing, and if you know how to take things constructively, then do it. But if you know, you kind of know inside of you if the criticism is constructive or not. You kind of know, your gut feeling will tell you if it's given out constructively or for you to take it constructively. It's really up to you. But you may not have the control over what other people tell you, but you have the full absolute control over how you take them. So yeah, that's number one. Number two, I wrote here, okay, I think this is really important. Paint what you love, don't paint to sell. And I know this may be taken differently from different perspective, because we all do artwork with different reasons behind. I do my paintings because I want to paint, and I even paint it even, you know, without someone telling me to paint it or to do it. I even paint whenever I want. You know, I don't schedule myself to paint in a particular hour. I just want to paint. Like, I make sure that every day I do some like art related stuff because it makes me feel good and it makes me feel fulfilled. But I cannot deny that some people are earning because of the painting, and they are skilled people, and I must say that I admire them for all the skills that they have, because yeah, I do realism, and I really like skillful artists because it helps in creating realistic paintings. But then my point here is that if you paint what you love, you don't need the external motivation to do it, because all you have to have is your willingness to do it for yourself. No one can actually tell you that it's not a job, to be honest. Don't treat it as a job, because once you treat it as a job, then you will feel motivated because of money. You'll feel motivated because of your, what do you call this? You just want to impress people and get their approval or something like that. And it's a sad thing to me, or it's a sad situation to be in, you know, to be at the mercy of other people for them to like you. You don't have to when it comes to artworks. I mean, this is my opinion, and I guess this is a universally accepted advice that any artist can give you if you're just starting. So don't be scared to paint for yourself, because of course people will ask you to paint something for them, either for money or for nothing. But just make sure that what you do is what you love, because you'll be spending a lot of time on an artwork. It's not an easy or a time consuming activity. It will really consume your time, unless maybe you're just you know, doodling or something. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, I think I forgot to breathe. Okay, next tip for you is to be proud of your artwork. Be proud of your artwork. Never trash talk your artwork. You know, I see on social media some people who post their artwork and then with a caption like, oh, I'm not really good at this, but here's my painting. It's not really pretty, but here's my painting. Like, I don't hate it because that's the way you deliver it, but I just don't see myself doing it, because I feel like I am like downgrading myself for something that I did. And if, you know, as cliche as it may sound again, if you don't believe in yourself, who do you think will, right? So don't expect others to believe in you if you don't believe in yourself. And don't post your artwork, or don't make your artwork of public view if you don't feel good about it. Because I don't know what's the point of doing that anyway. I'm so sorry, but that's my opinion. I mean, if you don't feel good about your painting, don't show it to the people and expect them to like it, and get hurt when they don't like it, right? My nose is getting runny, okay. So yeah, I'm not mad at people for doing those, but then again, it kind of sinks into you. As time goes by, if you keep doing it, it becomes a part of you, it becomes a habit, and subconsciously you keep doing it, and you send out some negative vibe around the people. And if you think that your artwork is not really good, some people will think, or most people, or all people will think that it's really not good. So my advice is for you to be proud of your work. You don't have to brag about it and keep rubbing it in. I'm just saying that when people compliment your artwork, try to receive it. Say thank you. You don't have to oppose what the other person told you. Like, let's say, oh, that is really beautiful. And then you go, no, it's not really pretty. Don't tell me that. Oh, you're just telling me that because you're my friend or something like that. Try to accept it. Say thank you. Because you put in all the hard work in there. And I assume that you put it out because you're ready to put it out. Okay? So I hope I make any sense. Okay. All right. My what? How? One, two. My third tip for you guys is to don't be concerned too much about brands. Okay. This is like confusing a bit because some people confuse brands with quality. And some people associate quality with brands. And I cannot blame them because some brands really offer good quality. But think of it this way. For those starting out, I won't advise you to spend a lot of money for an expensive brand. I really won't advise you because you will always be scared to use that paint. And well, if you're rich or if you're willing to spend a lot of money for that, then that's fine. But I'm talking about practicality and really using your talent to really focus on your talent more than the external factors around you. So when I started out, I actually used a poster paint or some poster paints, and I didn't even know what to use them for. It was pretty cheap. I think I bought that from Daiso, you know, the Japanese, like a dollar store. So it was really cheap, and I tried to paint using that for my first painting. And it was all right. Like, I didn't have any problem with that. I was able to practice using cheap paints, and it made me feel good. You know, you don't have to feel bad when you don't get the recommended products by other people. These products are just, usually they are for money. Usually, all right? I'm not telling that it's a bad thing. And really, I cannot lie that some brands really offer good quality. Let's say Winsor & Newton. Kind of expensive, but really amazing product like that. For canvases, I really don't care about the, like this one. I really don't care about the brand for this one. Because when I came back from Seoul, and now I'm here in Manila, I realized that I can use some other brands without actually, you know, there's no big difference. There's no difference at all. It was just maybe like matter of mindset that if you think that you're going to achieve a good painting just because you use branded products, that's a no-no, because your sense of achievement will be based on some external factors that that are produced by other people that are subject to demand and supply, and they can be gone. And what if they're gone, right? So yeah, just don't attach quality to brands. Be practical. At the same time, don't thrift so much that you're not even willing to invest in something that will really make you happy in terms of artwork. You know, learn to balance things. Like, if you have a fan brush and there's a good brand or a popular brand of fan brush, there's no really big difference. Sorry guys, my nose is quite runny. So yeah, I'm just telling you guys to be practical and don't spend or don't overrate those products when it comes to your ability to paint. Okay. Okay, so I think this is my last tip for you guys. Okay, Don't look for motivation. Don't look for motivation. What is the meaning of this? Your motivation should not be externally sourced out from anyone, from anything. Of course, sometimes I'm motivated, let's say, when I watch a documentary, a film by someone, and they are featuring my favorite artist, Van Gogh. Then I feel so inspired and motivated to paint and grab my paintbrush and canvas and all that. But make sure that you're not dependent on the existence of that thing or person in making your decision whether or not you want to paint or you want to create. Of course, being inspired by other people is a good motivation, but just make sure that it's coming from the inside as well. That no matter what happens, even if people motivate you or not, you can still do it. And you know you, right? Motivation, some people actually say that they have this creative rut, that they can no longer paint. They just woke up one day, don't know how to get it back and all that. But for me, I'm not being an idealist or something like that. I'm not. I'm actually a realist, to be honest. But I'm an optimist as well. So imagine me. If I source out my motivation externally, I wouldn't be able to paint like hundreds of paintings. And I'm not even selling, like, I'm not, you know, intentionally selling them. I'm just posting, I'm just creating, I'm showing the world this is how I paint, and I'm so enjoying it. You know, that's the difference between a person who just enjoys doing it than a person who is actually desperate, I'm sorry for the word, but desperate to have it sold or for other people to get it. And people can sense that desperation from you, that you just want that painting sold, and they're gonna go like, maybe there's something wrong with this painting, that's why he or she wants to get it sold like immediately, and selling yourself short or selling your painting short of the value that it actually has for you, especially when you put in all the work and effort and time, right? So again, motivation should come from the inside. And if another person motivates you to do it, make sure that you find something in yourself that will make you hold on to that creativity that is already inside you. You know, you don't let it go simply because that thing goes away, that person goes away, or that person leaves you. So one internal motivation that will really help you, an example would be, I'm going to apply it to myself, or I'm going to cite myself as an example, would be, as corny as it may sound, is the sense of fulfillment that I get whenever I accomplish a painting. It's priceless. Like, that's why people ask me, why are you so like clingy on your paintings, like you don't want to sell them? Because I really think that my paintings form part of me, and that my paintings are a piece of me, and I just couldn't let them go. Of course, I've already let go some of my paintings. Some people bought it, some people got it for free. So the thing here is that I am motivated not because I'm earning from my paintings, but because I feel fulfilled when I do it. So, yay! So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed that one, and I really hope you learned something from me. You know, it's not always all the time that I do this kind of videos. So anyway, I'll be painting later, and I still don't know what to paint, but I think I have one thing in mind. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys.